The St. Paul Rodeo is back. There is bull riding, barrel racing, and other competition that bring cowboys and cowgirls to St. Paul from across the country.
Yeah, this is really a favorite in the region. The rodeo kicks off today, starting at a 5-day 4th of July rodeo week. Cor Harlan live in St. Paul this morning, checking out the grounds, meeting some of the bulls. Cor.
Man, what a good place. The bull to meet the bull this morning here from St. Paul Rodeo, where the rodeo gets started. This is, by the way, the largest 4th of July rodeo in the nation. Cowboys from 30 states and 3 provinces will be here competing for almost $400,000 worth of prize money. So it's a big deal. This is Tim Bridwell here, who's from Red Bluff, California. I said your name right, didn't
yes,
I?
The yes, last sir.
Name?
Yeah.
Very good. All right. And you own the bulls. You're bringing the bulls to the party, right?
Yeah.
Let's have Carl kind of peek through the fence there, because we got some feed here and they know where we're coming here. So Tim, pop some of that feed in there and let's see him come on here. You just dump it right in there.
Yeah,
that's good stuff. All right, they know it's feeding time,
feeding,
don't they?
Space it out a little bit. So
yeah, that's
they
good
both will come up.
While you're working there, would you tell me just a little bit about the majesty of these bulls? Because I have been up on that platform above the chutes once or twice, and I just talking to you about this a little bit. These animals are magnificent athletes, and I mean that in a truest sense. You do not recognize the athleticism. You've been talking to it. You see it all the time. It's a real shock to me to see something that big twist around and pirouette and do ballet essentially in the air with a cowboy on his back.
Well, that's right. That's absolutely what they are. They're just animal athletes, you know. And we were talking earlier. The thing of it is these bulls. The cowboys know them, and they develop a reputation, and it's important for us to bring high quality animals to especially a rodeo like St. Paul, because these cowboys fly all over the United States and Canada and wherever to try and make a living. So when they invest that much time and money to going ahead and coming across the country somewhere, they have to have an opportunity to win. So they have to have a good animal, because the animals have to score. So.
Right. That the harder the ride is, the more your score is.
Absolutely.
The more potential your score
absolutely,
is.
Absolutely.
Yes. Yeah. So this is what I'm told is like sort of Christmas, cowboy Christmas kind of, this week before and after 4th of July. You take these bulls all around the West, or how far is your range to take them?
Right, mainly the West Coast. Mm-hmm. You know, we go as far north as the Calgary Stampede sometimes, and then a lot around, you know, up into Puyallup, Washington, as far south as the Los Angeles area. Yeah, so we're basically a West Coast rodeo company, yes, sir.
I don't like that bull. What's that bull's name right there?
That's Who's Bad News.
Who's Bad News? I don't think he likes Carl too much.
Yeah.
Carl, I don't think he cares for you too much.
They're just nervous about what we're doing here, but if we step back a few feet, they would start eating.
Oh, that's all right. Who's Bad News? That's your name? Who's Bad News? He knows his name, doesn't he? Well, maybe not. Maybe not.
Here. Actually, that bull here a few years ago, Elliot Jacoby was 90 points on that bull here at St. Paul when we first got him.
Wow. Who's your bad news? Wow. All right, fellas, it's chow time. You can come over and eat now. We'll step back here. St. Paul Rodeo gets started tonight. Tonight at 7:30 here in the, it's just beautiful. The driving out here, the crops, the irrigation, the hops hanging up there, the smell of dirt, the smell of cow manure and bull manure is a good smell.
Yes, sir.
It's just a good smell. I mean, it's not something you can do it until you smell it, but you know it. When you smell, and it's just good. It's a good smell. The event starts tonight. Again, this is the largest 4th of July weekend rodeo in the country. Some of the best cowboys, the champion cowboys, will all be here this weekend. Some of them are riding the bulls here. Tim will have his bulls out here. Goes through Sunday. I don't know what else to say about it. All the bells and whistles are here. Food we're going to show you next hour. We got some trick riders going on here.
Is there a bull simulator?
Bull's taking a dump behind us here. That's just.
Is there something you?
There
can
is
hop
a
on?
Bull simulator. I don't know if we're gonna. No, not this year. Not this year. Not this year. We did that last year.
Oh.
We did that last year. Yeah, that was 2 years ago.
I mean,
I would have enjoyed it. I'm not gonna do that this year.
Mm-hmm. Well, I did enjoy him waxing poetic about bull manure. That was pretty fun.
That was interesting.
Yeah, yeah. I've never heard somebody describe
just
cow manure with so much love. You know.
It's a good smell. It's a childhood smell.
Oh,
okay.
It is a good smell. I like the smell.
Childhood smell. You grew up in Lake Oswego.
Yeah, I knew I did. There wasn't a lot of that in LO, I'll tell you that. Right. But,
some other all right, man. Look forward to it. St. Paul Rodeo, great event. It really is. Thanks, Corey.
Yeah, they have that fun tack room. Is that what it's called?
I think the bar out there is called the tack room.
That's pretty wild.
I just put on cowboy boots and headed out. Stuff like that.
You look good in cowboy boots.
I think so.
Oh, Carly was like, I got three pairs, so I see it's a reason to wear some. Yeah.
Cowboy boots are stylish.
They are.
I got a pair of cowboy boots, got a cowboy hat, the whole thing.
Oh, yeah.
I have some too. Yeah, same reason I like to wear them, just because they're cute. Yeah, dress up. Don't want to get on a bull or anything. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's talk traffic and weather right now. And weather-wise, we're talking about just the 80s today.
Yeah, the 80s today. This will be our coolest day in about 5 days. So we are on the backside of this heat wave. We're cool.